Hello and welcome. My name is Jörg Elten. I'm working for Ericsson and I'm going to present you today the NFV enhancements for containerized VNF orchestration, which is being introduced to the standard specification for the ETSI ISG NFV. So what will I present to you today? I will start to introduce the feature concepts. What is the feature introducing all these capabilities? Then I will continue with presenting the architectural enhancements to the NFV Mano system. Then following more details about the changes in the information model, especially on the descriptors and interfaces of the NFV Mano system. And finally, I give an outlook on the current status and approach we will take for profiling open source solutions. So starting, NFV is currently implementing its release 4. And one of the release 4 is a feature which is numbered 17. And the overall heading of this feature is cloud native VNFs and container infrastructure management. The overall scope for this release 4, it's also specified in the definition of the NFV release 4, is that it should provide solutions for NFV architecture support for VNFs which follow cloud native design principles. It's also there to enhance the NFV Mano capabilities to support container technologies and capabilities from container management and orchestration. Furthermore, as already mentioned at the content presentation, is that we are striving for enhancing the information model for containerized VNFs, both for bare metal and also for nested virtualization technologies. Besides enhancing existing ETSI NFV specifications, we have identified new work items as deliverables as part of these release 4 feature. That is in particular two new specifications for the interfaces and architecture group, numbered 36, which is the specification of requirements for management and orchestration of cluster nodes. Basically the specification for the container cluster management, and also number 40, which specifies the requirements for service interfaces and the object model for OS container management and orchestration. Then we have got also in our security working group, work item numbered 23, which takes care of the specification of container security. And for the later on, the stage 3 implementation in our solutions working group, we have got a work item number 18, which specifies the profiling of the protocol and data model solutions for OS container management and orchestration. How does it look like also in the implementation stages for this feature? In a stage 1, which specifies use cases, concepts and recommendations, in a study report, which is informative, that is IFA 29, the specification, and that work has been concluded and published end of 2019. Then following end of 2019, we started with the stage 2 implementation, which specified requirements on the new functions of the CISM and CIR. I will come more with details in later on in the, in the presentation. And we are also then in the stage 2 enhancing and providing new functional requirements. And we also enhance the information model of the VNF descriptor and the NFV Mano interfaces. So these normative specifications, the current status is that the IFA 36 on the container cluster management is still ongoing. It's being a work in progress. And the other specifications like IFA 40 and the enhanced VNF descriptor specifications, IFA 10 and 11, they have been published in its latest versions, May 2021. And also the main interface specifications with enhanced information models have been published also May this year. Ongoing, the stage 3, which is aiming for profiling and endorsement of de facto standard open source solutions, and also then corresponding to the enhancement of the information models. We are also enhancing the data models correspondingly. That is all work ongoing, which started beginning of this year. And that is the current status of the implementation stages. I would like to raise your attention to one approach where we took a little bit different concept and approach to specify the stage two as we did before with other interface specifications. And this applies especially for the IFA 40, which specifies the requirements on the interfaces on the OS container orchestration and management. First of all, in IFA 40, we specified an NFV object model, which provides a description and definition of the NFV object model in a kind of abstract way for the management and orchestration of the containerized workloads in NFV Mano. And this abstract terminology also enables us to map later on de facto standard solution objects in stage three. So that's the first kind of part for this specification approach. And furthermore, we only specify requirements on the exposed service interfaces of the new functions. We do not specify interface operations or information models. And this will enable us profiling of de facto standard open source solutions as a stage three. So we will profile them against the specified requirements, but we do not specify the dedicated interface operations or the information models themselves. And last but not least, we also only specify the producer side. So we do not put any constraints on potential consumers, and we do not apply a kind of direct reference point approach with a one-to-one mapping and relationship between consumer and producers. So it's only the producer side of the new APIs we would like to profile. And we also think here we enable flexible implementation of the services for different potential architectural options. How does the main architectural enhancements look like? With the black boxes here in the diagram, you might be familiar with the schematic high level structure of the NFV Mano system. And here in the blue boxes, you see that we have integrated in a schematic way the enhancements of this architectural framework. So first of all, we introduced a function which we call Container Infrastructure Service Management, the CISM. And to make it more, to give it a better grip on this one, it could be compared to like the control plane of the de facto standard solution of Kubernetes. Then we introduced the Container Image Repository, the CIR. You can think of that as being a kind of Docker image registry. And furthermore, we are also specifying the Container Cluster Management, the CCM, which would have its equivalent in open source solutions like KubeSpray, KubeADM, or the Kubernetes Cluster API. And you can see then we have certain integration points where we see the interaction with the existing NFV Mano system, but as said before, we're mainly specifying the requirements of the producer of these new functions. So what does IFA 40 provide in detail? You will see here the three columns of the main information and specification which are published in this document. First of all, we of course provide an overview and on the framework for this OS container management orchestration, but we also introduce and provide first the really formal normative specification of these new functions of the CISM and the CIR. Then furthermore, we also, as mentioned before, we provide the OS container NFV object model. So that's the formal normative specification of the managed objects in an abstract way, as I said before. And also we provide the information on the relationship to the existing NFV information model. So we introduce objects like the managed container infrastructure object, then also packages of these MCIOs. Then we also introduce the namespace, namespace quota, and OS container images. Then the main part of the requirement specification of the IFA 40 provides then the specification of the CISM interfaces and the services which provide these interfaces. And there we differentiate between OS container workload management services and then services for the management of OS container compute storage and network objects, while we also provide then a management service or requirements on the management service for the OS container configuration. Finally, we also specify the container image registry and requirements on this interface as well. And as mentioned before, all of that has been in its latest edition published in May this year in the IFA 40 specification. To fill this a little bit more with life, I provide a mapping of the terms from these abstract terminology we have specified in the ETSI specifications and provide some analogy to the de facto standard open source solutions to fill it a little bit more with life. So when we talk about a container infrastructure service, a CIS, that would equivalent to Kubernetes services, which are exposing the lower level CRI, CNI, and CSI interfaces. And an instance of such a CIS, you could understand as one Kubernetes worker node. In contrast then, the control plane for Kubernetes provided by the Kubernetes master node and also parts of them with the corresponding Helm 3 client, that would be the Container Infrastructure Service Management, the CISM. Then coming to the managed objects and their packaging, the managed container infrastructure objects, the MCIOs. These would be Kubernetes managed objects. So for example, deployments, a stateful set, persistent volume claim, services, and so on. So all of these resource objects, which are exposed by the Kubernetes APIs, these are examples for an MCIO. And in order to provide then the object packages, and especially their packaging of the declarative descriptors, that would be an MCIOP. And the analogy then in the de facto standard solutions would be that such an MCIOP is represented by a Helm chart. Then furthermore, we have, of course, introduced new functions like the CISM and the CIR. And correspondingly, we have also provided functional requirements on these functions. And these new functional requirements, they are specified in the release 4 edition of the existing IFA specification numbered 10. And here we have then new functional requirements that have been introduced in this release. On these new functions, CISM and CIR, and they are basically also specifying the requirements on the resource management and all the service and management functions, which are expected to be provided by these new functions. But on top of that, we also enhance the functional requirements on the NFV Mano functional blocks, the NFV Orchestrator and the VNF Manager. So the NFV orchestrator functional requirements are extended with requirements to consume the OS container configuration management service interfaces exposed by the CISM. The NFVO is also expected to consume OS container image management service interfaces exposed by the CIR. And also the NFVO is extended with the functional requirements to support the storage of MCIOPs in an MCIOP repository. In a similar way, the VNF manager is also expected to consume OS container management service interfaces exposed by the CISM. These are the main functional requirements on the VNF manager in order to support the possibility to consume both the Helm client and also the Kubernetes native APIs. And finally, also the VNF manager, is expected to provide functional capabilities to consume the OS container image management services in order to query information on available OS container images. So this is overall the set of functional requirements which are specified in IFA 10 and which are then also provided and published in May this year. To give you an outlook over the IFA 36, the specification on the cluster management, the container cluster management, as I've mentioned before, this is a work in progress. This is ongoing. Therefore, I'm only showing one schematic overview so that you get an idea about the scope and the domain where the container cluster management is applied. So here you can see in different colors all the different components for the different layers of the container cluster in the services, the management layer, and also other concepts like namespace and the division into and grouping into container clusters and the control and the worker nodes and the different deployment scenarios, like having a nested virtualization technology, which you see more on the left hand side, where the container layer is implemented on top of a hypervisor based virtualization layer, while the right hand side represents more the deployment scenario of a container cluster layer deployed on a bare metal nodes. As said, this is work in progress, and the IFA 36 is expected to be published roughly beginning of next year. Then, also very important, it's not only that the specifications of the information models of the descriptor and the interfaces gets modified. We also had to enhance and change certain important term definitions. So as you might recall, we have a term which specified the VNF component, the VNFC, and this is the internal component of a VNF, providing a VNF provider a defined subset of that VNF's functionality. And previously, the old definition of this term VNFC is related that one of this VNFC component maps one-to-one against a single virtualization container. And that has been changed because due to the fact that we have also now container technology and the modeling enables that one component can be implemented by one or multiple containers, the one-to-one mapping to one container did not hold any longer. And that's why we have enhanced and changed the term definitions for a VNFC and for a VNFC instance and replaced it with a more generic term of an atomic deployable unit. And as an example, one atomic deployable unit is represented then by a single VM for hypervisor-based virtualization, or can be one or a set of OS container in case we have VNFC implemented via OS virtualization. You will find these changed terms, while also a lot of new terminology coming with OS container orchestration and management in our GR. This is a group report for NFV numbered 003 and its version and latest version, which has been published March this year. It contains a lot of these new terminology. Now, getting into changes in the VNF descriptor and their information model changes. First of all, the specification, of course, also, as you might know, contains requirements on the package content for a VNF package. And here we have introduced new requirements stating that a VNF package shall contain one or more MCIOPs. So this MCIO packages, in case the VNF package is a package for a containerized VNF, then also we have the new requirement that the VNF descriptor shall support the possibility to reference one or more MCIOPs. And of course, also we specified new requirements that the VNF descriptor shall support the possibility to reference OS container images. This is all new requirements on the VNF package content due to the introduction of containerized VNF components. Then the VNF descriptor information model got major enhancements and changes due to the possibility to model also containerized VNFs. First of all, we introduced a completely new information element. It's called OS container descriptor, and this holds the information model and represents all the resource requirements for one OS container. Then, as said before, a VNF component or its descriptor equivalent, the virtual deployment unit, the VDU, now should also be able to be implemented by one or a set of OS containers. We had to enhance the VDU information element to model one managed container infrastructure object as a VDU, like, again, in a analogy to the open source solution, we wanted to have the possibility to model a Kubernetes pod as a VDU. So the VDU information element has been enhanced with an attribute to reference one or more of these OS container descriptors. Then further enhancements to the VNF descriptor have been that the VNFD information element itself we added an attribute which enables to reference included MCIOPs in the package. So we have basically enabled the VNF descriptor to reference one or multiple Helm charts. And from a descriptor point of view, we now allow to model and describe in a VNF descriptor to describe hybrid VNFs. So in principle, we can have certain VNF components which are VM-based and other VNF components which are container-based. So the overall VNF would be hybrid, consisting out of components which are VM-based and ones which are container-based. So there's no restriction. We can, of course, still have, as before, purely VM-based VNF components, or now new, mainly pure OS container-based VNF components, but we can also have hybrid VNFs. However, we do forbid hybrid VNFC. So each VNF component can only be modeled and specified by one virtualization technology. So one VNFC can only be described to be either VM or OS container based. And furthermore, we have also enhanced the information element for the software image descriptor to reflect better the capabilities of OS container images. So there have been several changes in the cardinality and applicability of certain attributes of this information element. But that was not even all. So we had even further changes and enhancements of the VNF descriptor information model. So we enhanced the virtual storage descriptor, which with additional attributes to indicate if the storage shall be used by, as a template for all VNFC instances, which was the current and backward compatible semantic. But we also introduced that we can indicate if this storage instance shall only be created once, and then potentially could also be shared between VNFC instances. Then going on, we also added a descriptor information element for an MCIOP profile to the VNF deployment flavors. So this enables us also to model and represent the relationship between a Helm chart and a certain VNF deployment flavor, and of course all the VNF components which are included in one of these VNF deployment flavors. We enhanced as well the scope of the affinity and anti-affinity groups information element, so that we also now can specify affinity or anti-affinity rules with the scope of the container namespace, which did not exist before. Then talking about the connectivity and the networking, we changed the cardinality of the internal connection point attribute of the VDU information element. So we changed it from mandatory 1 to n to 0 to n. That allows to have the that one VDU does not have to have a VDU connection point. And this was necessary in order to model the case when the implementing containers would only connect to the container cluster internal network, so that we did not have to model always internal connection points for all VDUs. On the other hand, we enhanced and provided a new connection point descriptor type, which is now the virtual connection point descriptor. And that is a dedicated new information element, which enables us to model and describe specific primary container cluster external network connection properties. And basically, this new information element we are using to model MCIOs like the Kubernetes service or ingress objects. Finally, but last but not least, we have also enhanced the VDU information element with a new attribute, MCIO constraint parameters. And these parameters and values, they specify standardized semantical context of the MCIO constraints. And we can use this mechanism in order to specify certain parameters which are used and interpreted by the container scheduler, utilizing labels of the nodes, and these label values then would express certain certain semantics which are used in order to control the placement of individual VNF components. To give you a little bit more a graphical overview about the main changes of the information model of the virtual deployment unit, the VDU inside the VNF descriptor, you can see that on one hand, here in the bottom, in the middle, we have the new information element of an OS container descriptor with a multiple cardinality to be referenced from one VDU. So this is the new information element for one or a set of individual OS containers. The virtual compute descriptor, which was beforehand the only descriptor for a VDU to provide the resource requirements for VM-based components. There we have changed the cardinality, so that was mandatory before, but as we now introduce also the option of an OS container descriptor, the cardinality of this descriptor element has been changed. And the virtual storage descriptor can now not only be referenced from the VDU, but it can also be from the lower level, component of the OS container descriptor. And as mentioned before, also the cardinality of the VDU connection point information element that has been changed. All of these changes are available in the latest release 4 edition of the IFA 11 specification, and as said, also available since May of this year. Then I will continue with the information model enhancements, but here in this case, I continue with the enhancements on the information model of the NFImano interfaces. And as you might imagine, most enhancements and changes, they have been applied to the interface information model of the ORVNF-M reference point interfaces, which is between the NFV orchestrator and the VNF manager. And here we have introduced the following changes. We have now enhanced the all the VNF lifecycle management operations and also constraint values that can be also assigned to MCIOs. And we are able to convey the namespace value for all of these objects like the MCIOs via the grant respond message. And this enables us that the NFV orchestrator can convey the container cluster namespace as a kind of isolation area under which certain resource objects shall be deployed. So that enables the control from the orchestrator to decide in which namespaces certain VNF components and their corresponding container infrastructure objects will be deployed. Correspondingly also used in the granting exchange between the VNF manager and the NFV orchestrator, the resource definition information element has been enhanced with attributes with references to OS container resource definition types and resource templates. So as in correspondence to the enhancements of the VNF descriptor that we have now also OS container descriptors and stuff like this. Of course, these type of resource definition templates need also be able to be referenced in the granting exchange. Furthermore, then the description of the access information for software images and other artifacts for external access have been aligned so that we can also reference software images like container images and corresponding artifacts which are used for the container-based components. Then on not only for the lifecycle management operations, as described before, certain enhancements were required, but also the information elements for the runtime model had to be enhanced, so that now corresponding also to the information model of the descriptor of the different VNF components and elements, also correspondingly, the information elements of the runtime model, like the VNF info and its sub-elements, had to be extended for the models of the OS container. And now we also have one new information element, which is called MCIO info, which provides a new information element to represent the runtime information of an MCIO. And that includes also information about the desired state and the available number of instances and so on. That's basically an intermediate level in the runtime model, which enables us to represent information about Kubernetes objects like a deployment or, as I said before, a Kubernetes service and so on. Then not only the workload specific information model has been enhanced on this reference point, but also we enhanced the information element for the Vim connection information so that we also can now provide and cover connectivity and access information for the CISM and also for the MCIOP repository and for the container image repository. So that is also an extension. And furthermore, we have also enhanced the output parameters for the granting of the VNF lifecycle management operations and the VNF info information elements, so that we have now attributes to access information to these registries. So it's the connection info to Vim connection info that is used for the connections as such, but also then new attributes to model the new registry types for the container images and the MCIOPs. This is all available in the release 4 specification edition 4.2.1 of the IFA 7. Then going on in alignment with the changes of the OR VNFM reference point, similar enhancements had to be applied to the information models of the other reference points and the interfaces because they're fairly similar. So the interfaces between the VNF manager and the exposed OSMA NFVO interfaces from the NFV orchestrator, they both have been aligned and extended with the same runtime information elements, like as explained before, the VNF info in the same way and in a consistent way as we've done that with the IFA 7. So these are the enhancements which you find in the IFA 8 and IFA 13. And also the descriptor for the NFV network service got a similar extension of the scope attributes for affinity and anti-affinity rules, also to be able to express affinity or anti-affinity based on container namespaces. And this could be found in the IFA 14 specification. Okay, so far around the information models, VNF descriptors, and enhancements on the interfaces. Let me go a little bit deeper into the stage three specifications, which is usually then specifying the protocols and the data models of these solutions. As explained at the beginning, we are taking a different approach here. So as you might remember, in IFA 40, we have specified the corresponding requirements on the management service interfaces exposed by the functions of the CISM and the CIR. And here now we have the corresponding specification, which we would like to set up in a way that we profile existing de facto standard open source solutions like Kubernetes Helm and the OCI distribution specification against those requirements we have specified in the stage two. So how does it look like in more detail? First of all, as you might remember, we have in IFA 40 specified the abstract NFV object model for OS container management and orchestration. And here now in the specification SOL 18, we map those abstract NFV object model against the concrete managed objects from the Kubernetes and Helm data model, as they are specified by the Cloud Native Compute Foundation, the CNCF. So that's the first important part of this stage three of the profiling specification, so that we get the connection between the more abstract object model specification in the stage two in IFA 40. And now we fill it basically with live and map those objects with the de facto standard solution objects from those data models from Kubernetes and Helm. But we are not only mapping the objects themselves, but we also provide a mapping of common input and output parameters, which we derive from the information or data models from the VNF descriptor, the network service descriptor, and also from the data models of the NFV Mano RESTful APIs. And we map those, or some of these selected parameters and attributes from these data models, to input output parameters and associate them to properties and fields of these managed objects from Kubernetes and Helm. So on a higher level, as said before, we are mapping the abstract object models against the real objects from the de facto standard open source solutions. But in more detail, we also provide a mapping on which properties, attributes, parameters from the NFV data model map to which fields and properties of the Kubernetes and Helm data model. And then also a very important part is, of course, the individual profiling of these de facto standard solutions, their APIs. And therefore, we will profile the reference Kubernetes API as the NFV protocol and data model solution for the OS container management orchestration. We also go and profile the reference Helm documentation as the NFV protocol and data model solution for the management of OS container workloads, which are based on MCIOPs. So that's yet another higher abstraction level. We have two abstraction levels. We have the Kubernetes API, and we have the Helm CLI as different groupings and abstraction of the managed objects from the container platform. And we will also profile the reference OCI distribution specification API as the NFV protocol and data model solution for the OS container image management. So recently, the Open Container Initiative, the OCI, they also published and endorsed the distribution specification, which was previously the Docker registry API. And this is now being officially endorsed and adopted by the OCI. And we will also profile these API as the protocol for the container image management. Overall, our approaches, as during the development of this specification, the SOL 18, we will kind of adapt and follow also to the latest published version of these reference documentation of all these APIs we are profiling. So in case there are changes during the development of our specification, we will update and follow always and then profile against the latest published version of these reference documentation. And then last but not least, we will also provide guidelines and rules in SOL 18 on how these profiled and the reference solutions, they can be adopted in a way that to explain how to facilitate them as an integration with the NFV-MANO framework. That is the scope and the work which is currently ongoing on the profiling of this de facto standard open source solution for container management in the specification of SOL 18. A little bit more detail, how does the structure or the envisioned structure of this document, which is work in progress, look like? And that is very much corresponding to the scope, as I've just explained. So we will start with an overview of the protocols and the data models for the OS container management and orchestration. Then we have a clause which explains the NFV object model mapping to the profile solution objects. Then one clause on the in and output parameter mapping between the data models. And then the individual clauses on the profiling of the management service interfaces. I don't have to list them here again, but these are basically all these APIs I have just mentioned before. And of course, then we will provide in an annex. It's not decided yet if that will be of a normative provision or if it will only be informative, the guidelines on the integration of these profile solutions. On the right-hand side, you have a schematic illustration of the high-level concept of the container control plane provided by the CISM, the Container Infrastructure Manager. It exposes the API, which would then be represented also in an implementation by our profiled solutions. And we would have a consumer of such a control node. And the invocation of such an API would then contain of the actual API call. It will reference the corresponding declarative descriptor of the workload to be deployed in an MCIOP. So think of as an Helm chart. And we will also have a specification of the values for the in and output parameters. So that's how we envision such a call of such an API. And the API itself, as said, we are going to profile against the solution which is provided by the open source project. As said, also here in the link, when you later on have access to the presentation material, it's a work in progress, but it's public. So you can always access the latest draft and follow the development work of this SOL 18 specification. To give you also an outlook on how does the data model of the VNF descriptor will look like, here is the schematic UML model in its current draft in the SOL 1 specification in its release 4 edition. And there you can see that corresponding to the enhancement of the information model of the VNF descriptor in IFA 11. We also have here new data types. In particular, we have split now the modeling, as you might also know from previously, that the modeling of the VDU information element resulted in multiple different data types in the data model. We have now a new data type for the OS container deployable unit. And with this, we are able to model directly the MCIOs, the managed container infrastructure objects. So we could model such a Kubernetes deployment object or a Kubernetes stateful set object would be represented then by one instance of this data type of OS container deployable unit. It has certain capabilities and requirements to model connections to, as I said, the new connection point type, for example, which is the virtual CP that has been taken over from the information model of the VNF descriptor also into the data model. So we have a new data type for a virtual CP for this new type of connection point. We have a new data element to model the MCIOP, which is the Helm chart with certain capabilities. And here we can also associate them to a VDU, which is here in the data element of the OS container deployable unit. And also one deployable unit can then model the relationship via requirement and capability to one or multiple OS container data types. So the VDU OS container data type will express the individual resource requirements of one OS container, but the cardinality can be one to n. So multiple OS containers can be grouped and referenced from one OS container deployable unit, in accordance also how most of the de facto open source solutions are providing and modeling those descriptors. That is most of the information I wanted to share. So also here, the SOL 1, it's still work in progress. Same as for SOL 18, it's possible to follow the development work in the open file server from Etsy, where you have access to the latest draft. And the link you will find also here in the documentation. If you also are interested in further information, we are infrequently providing certain smaller tutorials, which we call NFV Bits. We have got an own YouTube channel for these ones. As mentioned before, if you're interested in following the development of the ongoing work items, you can follow them in the document box from Etsy in the NFV Drafts folder. Of course, here's a link also provided for our published work, which you can find. And then we also are issuing now and then blog posts and press releases and so on. So these are here the links where you can find further information. That's all from my side. I would like to thank you for your attention following my tutorial. And I would like to say goodbye. Thank you and goodbye.